Hi, in this video, we'll be creating persistent volume claim, and see how we can use that inside the pod. So first, let's check whether any PV or PVC is present on this cluster. So we do not have any persistent volume. We don't have any persistent volume claim. Now we'll create the PV. So in this particular demo, we'll be using static provisioning, means we'll be creating the persistent volume manually. So you can see the kind is persistent volume, the name is demo PV, storage class is manual, and we define the capacity, access mode, read write once, and the host path. So basically it is a host path which is just used for testing purposes and not in production. But for this particular demo, we'll stick to a host path, meaning it will be mounting the directory /mnt/data from one of the hosts, which is on the cluster. So I already have a node which is part of this particular cluster, and this directory, you can see if I do a pwd, I have created a file called index.html with contents as hello inside this directory. So now let's create this pv, kubectl create -fpv. Pv is created. Now next step is to create the pvc. So kubectl, first, let's see the contents, cat PVC. So persistent volume claim, kind is persistent volume claim, and the name is demo PVC claim. Again, storage class name is manual, and read write access mode should match the PV, and the resources that we are requesting is 3 gigs. So kubectl create -f PVC. Okay, let's see if our PV and PVC is created. They both are created, and the status is bound, means the PV has been bounded to the PVC. So basically both their status is bound. So, and the storage class is manual. So we have things ready to be used inside a pod. So let's see the contents of the pod now. So we in this particular scenario, I'm targeting this to on the specific node where that particular directory is present, so that it takes the Nginx file, because the volume. So first of all, to use persistent volume inside a pod, you have to specify in the pod section spec volumes, give as persistent volume claim, and give the name of the persistent volume claim. So in this particular case, we created a PVC with the name demo PV claim. So in the volume section, we have provided persistent volume claim with the claim name as demo PVC claim. And the node name is where the directory and the index.html file was already created. And then it's a simple Nginx container. In the volume mount section, we are mounting the volume, the PV volume, which is defined above, to the mount path /user/share/nginx/html. Now let's go ahead and create this pod. So kubectl get pods. We have this container creating and it's running. So our pod is running, and we can exec into the pod, kubectl exec -it -sh, and let's go to the directory user share nginx html. We should be having index.html. So it has the content. So, and if we do a curl localhost, it's there. If I exit and do kubectl get pods -o wide, and with the local IP as well, it should be giving us the hello. So basically, we have successfully mounted the PV persistent volume inside a pod. So now when we delete the pod, kubectl delete pod. Which is tasks PV pod. So the pod is getting deleted. And we can still see the file is already there. So we have the file and basically we have the data. And we don't have the pod. So we also have PVC and PV. So in this particular case, since the reclaim policy is also retained, and even if you delete the PVC, the PV won't get deleted. And even if you delete the PV, the host path volume, which is the slash MNT slash data, won't get deleted. So all these have to be manually deleted. So that's how it's a very simple example of how to basically use persistent volume and persistent volume claim inside a pod. That's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.